Hello, hello, welcome back, people. Now, there is hardly anyone from a certain generation who has not heard of the band Overlord. Now, Overlord exploded onto the scene a couple of years back and mesmerized all and sundry with their obsessive overload of percussion that not only included the drums that the main man of the band is famous for, but also the desi dhol that you and I secretly love. Initially known as the band without a song, Overlord comfortably segued into songs with their second album featuring the eclectic Misha Shafi, but that union ended in a very public feud, forcing or rather paving the way for the band leader himself to exchange his drumsticks for a microphone. Please welcome the man with the magic fingers who has also proved that he has as much passion in his singing as well, Farhad Humayun. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Very well. How are you?
Good to have you here, Farhad. I must say that we have wanted to have you on the show for a while now.
I wanted to be on the show, but you know that musicians wake up late.
I know, yes.
We're in the
studio,
we spend nights working on music. So it's good to be here. Thank you for having me.
But we are glad that you do spend those nights working on music because you've got some great music. We love it. It's very different.
Thank you so much.
So Farhad, you obviously were a drummer. How do drummers?
I still am.
You are, of course, but you are also a singer now.
Okay.
Vocalist.
I don't know if I'm comfortable with that.
Really?
Yeah.
Still not.
I've just sung one song. I've produced bands over the years. I've worked with singers over the years, and you know, I've learned a few things. I'm not really trained as a singer, but I'm a rock musician, and I think I do justice to that genre.
At least the song that you did do, and of course we will be playing it in a while, that looked as if it was coming from the heart.
It really is. Otherwise, there's no point in doing music. I mean, if you can't convince yourself of the words that you're saying, then the audience isn't going to be convinced either. So you have to believe in what you say and mean it.
Of course. And of course, we know with your drumming and we've seen the passion that you come out with, you're totally in it. You are probably as mesmerized by the whole sound of it as the audience that you are
playing
for.
It is an overwhelming experience when we're on stage and in the studio, because we're the loudest band in Pakistan. And the volume and the energy that's on stage is crazy. So it's inspiring to be on stage with these boys.
Absolutely. Now Farhad, how did you have the confidence that, okay, fine, you know, we are going out with a band and we have got the musicians, we've got the signs who also play the dhol and everybody, and people are going to go for it. There is no song, there are no lyrics, there's nothing in it. When you started off, you had the confidence that it would sell?
No, we didn't even want it to be a commercial thing. I mean, we're still not a mainstream commercial band, but we never thought we'd be playing concerts all over the world and doing festivals. We never thought about how people would react to it. But I guess it was just a strange mix of people visually, and the audio was also very strange to begin with, but very loud, and our audience loves volume.
Oh, absolutely. And who is your audience, by the way? Who are you targeting?
Well, I want to play for anyone who wants to listen. I mean, if you look at people who like hearing the dhol, then, you know, that's, it ranges from little kids to really old people. But I guess our main audience would be between the ages of 16 and 45.
Okay, which is a large chunk anyway. Everybody
it is.
Basically comes it is. In it. So, had it been just the drums and not the dhol that came in, you think that it would have made a similar impact?
No, probably not. But I think if now I were to collaborate with some of the biggest drummers in Pakistan, it would still be acceptable and interesting to watch. But, you know, the dhol and the drums are both very loud instruments.
True.
So we're like wrestlers, you know, or boxers in a match, and we're constantly fighting with each other. It's a dialogue between us on stage. So that makes it interesting.
Yeah. Actually, that dialogue and the gestures and the body language also, it comes across when we, you know, see
We're completely into the performance.
I mean, so we are going to show our viewers the latest rendition that you gave, Patti. And okay, we are going to play it, watch it, and then we come back. We'll be right back. Wow. Farhad, you have the energy, by the way, in your singing, like you play as well, because you're really singing. You know, you could sing from the soul, from the heart. You're singing from the gut. You're really going out with it.
That's the way it's meant to be done.
Okay, so tell us, is it like an answer to your earlier, and that was yours as well, your earlier song, Bijli, because this is Batti, that was Bijli. Mm. The sound is exactly the same. The composition is a little different. Tell us.
Well, that was 2009. Hmm. This is 2011. We had some more members in the band that are not here anymore. Hmm. I mean, yes, they're alive, but they're not in the band anymore.
Yeah, yeah. We've seen the lineup change over the years.
Yeah, and it has changed. It has been changing throughout. Just myself and Shiraz on keyboards were the two constant members.
Yeah.
I've been running the band since 2003. So this is our eighth year. And over the course of time, a lot of people have joined the band for a short burst and then left for their own reasons.
Okay.
This time, I felt that Overload needed to be self-sufficient, and that's what everybody in the band felt. And our singer had to go on maternity leave, but we still had to continue because we're professionals.
Of course.
So you need to continue with any work, whether, you know, a bank hires a lady who goes on maternity leave, the bank still continues, the company still goes on.
Yeah, but they don't really go out. Like in your case, Bijli and Batti, very similar. And the way you're singing and the way the lyrics are, it
that
does
was
seem
done
like
by a girl, this is done by a guy.
And it seems like almost like a Jawabi fire or something like that, for lack of a better term.
You could say that, but you know, it's not aimed at anybody.
Okay.
Yes. And we're just naturally born with an attitude, and maybe that's what is clicking in this particular song. And
so how did the court orders come in, and your singer, earlier singer of the band, Misha, you know, I wanted to Google find your song. I couldn't do it.
It's on YouTube, it's on our website, it's on Meta Cafe, it's on Facebook.
Okay.
It's all over the place. I don't know where you were searching.
Okay.
But
okay, now you can, you know now how hard I search for things.
No, it's everywhere.
So, but it does give a strip where there's a copyright issue going on or something. Do tell us about that.
Well, basically, when I had to drop her husband and wife from the band, they're new to the music industry, right? And a lot of new people don't understand how the music business works.
Okay.
We've been doing this over 10 years. In one capacity or the other, maybe in some cases as a producer I've been working. In this particular case, when I was served the order, I found it funny. Because, you know, I see people on the news who've killed other people and, you know, committed big crimes, and they're still roaming free. So, I mean, it's my property anyway. It's been proven, so what are you going to do about it? I still release the song.
Absolutely.
It's my song. So, you know.
And besides, you never hear about intellectual property rights here in Pakistan. At least, you know, nobody, I've never heard anybody sue anybody.
They apply. They apply, but music is an industry that's not really tapped into. I don't think people know that there is a lot of money involved in music now, as there is in fashion and entertainment. So a lot of people tell me, oh, it's just one song that you're fighting about. I say it's not just one song. This is a lifetime of work that's brought us here. And it's just as valuable as a piece of land, perhaps.
So when you guys made the Bijli one, this is obviously Batti, the Bijli one, who wrote the lyrics? Whose effort really went into it?
Okay, when a band works together, we've seen this with Jal and Atif Aslam also. We've seen this with a number of other bands. I think we have gone public with it, and Atif and Jal went public with it. Nobody else usually goes public with it, because nothing comes out of it. It's a very childish, you know, activity. So I got Nasir Sain to play dhol on it. I did drums on it. Shiraz did keyboards on it. Farhan did bass on it. Who else? Mehmood did guitars on it. Misha, I'd even composed the vocal melody for it. Misha came into the studio, she wrote the lyrics with the help of Shiraz, and she sang it. Like I told her to sing, because I produced the band. So you know, a producer is the music director.
Of course.
So it's a team effort. I don't say that they didn't have anything to do with it.
So out of all these people, like six, I think, of them that you quoted, you cannot just, one cannot claim that this is all mine. That is what you're saying.
Of course, I can claim it's mine because I pay for it.
Okay.
Right? I employ all these band members.
Huh.
I pay them. I pay their taxes also.
Okay.
So it's my property.
Hmm.
Even in the copyright law, the owner is described as the person who pays for the song.
Hmm.
And the person who composes the song, not the lyricist.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Legally, it's mine.
All right.
Do whatever you
so
like.
So when you were doing this version, Bijli to Batti, why, what made you change it? You wanted
the
to,
lyrics?
The lyrics, the
well,
composition.
Well, I was
bit.
Served a stay order, a restraining order, saying that basically you can't use this song. Now, legally and technically, Batti is a new song altogether, right?
True.
If you put, I can quote so many examples, if you put two songs side by side, even in the West, they may have the same chords playing on piano or guitar or some other instrument and a similar melody, but the lyrics are different.
The arrangement is different. It's very obvious. I think people who have heard both the songs would know that it, yes, they sound the same, but they are different.
They are two different songs altogether. I mean, of course, there's going to be a comparison because we used to have a girl in the band.
Of course.
And of course, she's famous doing what she does. But now the comparison is between me and her. And, you know, it's healthy. I like it.
We went out. We sent our team out and we asked people to tell us whether they liked they preferred this, Batti or Bijli. And we got some really interesting response that
interesting.
You know, we would like you to see. How about we play that? Okay, let's, here it is. You have to, Farhad, move here. This side. We'll be showing it.
Right.
Okay, they are still arranging it. But anyway, we got some interesting response and you will be surprised what people had to say.
Is better than Misha.
Batti's song is better than Bijli because I guess it has more passion.
I think Misha sang it better.
But I think Farhad sang it better.
Farhad's song is better than Bijli. I didn't like that song Bijli and I like Farhad's song.
Batti's song is better song than Bijli because I guess it is composed better.
Farhad composed it a little bit better.
I like Farhad's song. Farhad's song, but he's composed better.
Misha sang it better than Farhad.
Farhad is better than Misha.
I think Farhad's song, Batti, is more attractive comparatively.
I think so. Misha sang this song very well.
I think Farhad is more passionate in this song than Misha Shafi.
Song sung by Misha.
As far as composition is concerned, Farhad's composition is better than Misha's one.
If I talk about Sur, Farhad is more Surila than Misha.
Misha Shafi made it more glamorous.
I like Farhad's song, Batti.
I think Bijli sung glamorously, but Batti sung passionate.
Farhad's song is better than Bijli.
All right, so
that's an interesting perspective.
Yeah, and people are very perceptive. They really picked the passion and the glamour aspect
of it. I didn't know they were drawing so many comparisons, and I didn't know if people had heard this one or the previous one, you know. But it's interesting to see them.
But now you do, thanks to us. We
thank
kind
you so
of,
much.
You know, put this together for you. But the good part is that you own both the songs anyway. So
of course,
really, you know, it doesn't really matter which one is better. Of course, one you have more heart and soul in it.
The first one was also my composition.
Yeah.
Yes, she sang it. But this one is all mine because I feel like you know how they say that a person embodies something? I feel like I took in everything that this song needed and expelled it.
True.
So I do feel a lot for my music.
So do you think it has become even bigger than what you thought it would?
No, it hasn't. Because I mean, it was stopped on the internet, it was stopped on television. It could have been a lot bigger, but this controversy has really boosted it. And you know, I find people searching the web for it a lot and they don't find it.
Exactly.
But
exactly.
Yes, it's all over the web. It's on our website as well, which is overloadbeat.com.
Okay. It's going to be on our page as well, Facebook. We're going to make sure that we put it there. Okay, now that you have tasted that thing of, you know, singing, and I guess this was also the very first major song that you did. I'm sure that you sing on your own anyway.
Well, I have a recording studio, so I experiment with my voice a bit. But I haven't done any commercial work as a singer.
Okay, so what's coming up next?
We're doing a few old filmy songs.
Okay.
And we're remixing them so that the new generation sees that Pakistani music is also really good film music. And, you know, the West or Bollywood isn't the precedent.
Okay, so you are picking a Pakistani song.
That's not going to be a common practice. But yes, we have picked up a couple of songs from the Pakistani film circuit.
Okay.
And Sayyid Noor Saab has been very kind in that respect. He's given us a few songs to use. So he's not going to be suing us.
You've had the bitter taste now that this actually happens here in Pakistan.
It does. But we're also going to be continuing with our instrumental stuff, and we're going to be featuring other people also, because that is the philosophy of Overload. We get together with a lot of people, we throw a party, and we record music.
Yeah, we've heard tales of those parties, that it's a lot of, it doesn't almost, you know, feel like it's not work. I mean, you're working.
It's supposed to be
there,
fun when
but
you're
it's
working.
It's a lot of fun. Lovely, Farhad, thank you very much, by the way, for coming here,
clearing out
a lot of, you know, misconceptions, controversy, and being very candid about it.
Of course.
As well. So best of luck.
Thank you
so
much.
And inshallah, now that we have woken you up once, we are going to be waking you up once again.
Great.
All right.
It's good to wake up.
Okay. We are going to take a very short break, and then we come back close to the show.